Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace and blessings of Allah to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. The topic is what Al-Quran says about the Torah, Arabic word Torah, translated as law, the law in English. In Injil, Arabic word translated as the good news. This is the topic. These two words are commonly shared between the Christian world. The Christian world by themselves, they also believe that they have got the Torah with themselves and they have got the gospel translation of Injil with themselves. So I will be comparing the Bible and the Quran in the connection of these two words, the Torah and the Injil. And in that connection, first of all, I would like to discuss about the Bible. When I use the word Bible, be particular when I use the word Torah and when I use the word Injil. So you must know, when I say Bible, as I hold in my hand, it is written on the Bible, it's Holy Bible. Now, how does it contain the word Torah, a Hebrew word Torah, which is translated in Arabic as Torah, how does it contain, first I'll explain that. And then the Gospel translated of the Injil, Arabic word, how these two words that have occurred in this book, the Holy Bible. First from the Bible, and then what the Quran has to say about these two words, the Torah and Injil. This is the topic you're going to listen. So first of all, I have to explain to you what the Bible is. The Bible I hold in my hand contains, if you open this first page, contains the Old Testament and the New Testament, which means that certain part of the Bible, the first part of this Bible, every Bible of the world, contains the Old Testament. From Adam to Moses, the time period described in the Bible, they have referred in the Old Testament, which is believed by the Jews themselves as the only book they believe, the first part of this Bible. The second part is the New Testament. There are certain books in the New Testament, and this Old Testament and New Testament put together is the Bible which the Christians believe. The Christians believe the Old Testament and the New Testament put together as the Holy Bible, they believe this. But the Jews only believe the first part, that is the Old Testament. They believe that. They only believe that. So in the Old Testament, there are 46 books in the Douay version, a name given to the Bible, Douay version. There are many versions of the Bible. So I'm just referring to one of the versions, that is the Douay version. And the other is the King James version. So in the Old Testament, there's a difference between the Douay version and the King James version. And that is with 38 books in the King James version. The New Testament that is believed by the Christian world, both, contains 27 books. Meaning this book I hold in my hand contain books of the Old Testament books. I mean, listen to the English. The book I hold in my hand contains the books of the Old Testament, the books of the New Testament, and the book is one I hold in my hand, is a book. But it contains books that in the general terminology should be referred as a chapters. But the Christian world and the Jewish world, they say these are the books. So the first five books of the Old Testament that is referred as Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. The first five books of the Old Testament. These are referred as the Pentateuch or the Torah of the Hebrew word Torah of the Jews. Now the word Torah Akams, meaning in the Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers and Deuteronomy, the first five books contains the Torah, and that in these books is written that Moses got the Torah. Moses got the Torah. This is what is written in the first five books. And if you ask a Jew, or if you ask a Christian, that Moses was got the Torah, where is the Torah that he got Torah? And who gave this Torah? So they will say the first five books are the Torah, is the Torah. The first book, five books, is basically are the Torah. This is accepted by the Jews and the accepted by the Christians. The Torah is that in this book, Moses was preaching the Torah. What the Torah is, no description, the whole book, five books. But five books are referred as Pentateuch, as referred as Torah. The second part for the New Testament is the first four books, Gospel according to Mark, Gospel according to Matthew, Gospel according to John, and Gospel according to Luke. These are the four Gospel writers. Gospel in Arabic means Injil, translated as Evangel, or translated as Gospel, or Good News, or Glad Tidings. These are the translation in English and like that. So these Gospel that I am referring to, in these four Gospels, Gospel according to Mark, Gospel according to Matthew, Gospel according to Mark and Luke and John, in these Gospel writings, it is written down that Jesus preached the Gospel. In these five Gospel writings, according to Mark and Matthew, Luke and John, they are telling us that Jesus preached the Gospel. Jesus preached the Gospel. Jesus preached the Injil in these four, Matthew, Mark and Luke and John. So now when you ask the Christian, where is the Gospel? They say according to Mark, according to Matthew, according to Luke and according to John, they say that Jesus preached the Gospel, and Gospel means the Good News. What is the Torah? Not defined in the whole Bible. What is the Gospel? Injil is not defined in the whole Bible. But these two words have occurred in the Old Testament and the New Testament, and then they are telling us the first five books is the Torah, the four Gospel writings, and in that writings we see, they say that there are statements there that Jesus preached the Gospel, and in the five books they say Moses was given the Torah. Torah of the Hebrew word, translated in Arabic as Torah. This is the standpoint of a Jew and a Christian. Now we have to see, and this was to Moses got the Torah, is written down in these five books. And in the Gospel according to Mark and Matthew, Luke and John, that Injil was given to Jesus. This is the standpoint of the Jews and the Christians according to the Bible. Now we will see what the Quran has to say about the Torah and Injil. That is the topic. But further, I would like to tell you something more, that I have to explain to you that there are, if you open this page, this staple page, that refers to attributes, names of Al-Kitab. Staple page, right? Now before I discuss this, about what the Quran has to speak about the word Torah, because the word Torah has occurred in the Quran, and the Injil, the word, has occurred in the Quran. How they are explained and how it is written down, I will discuss that later according to ayats. But I would like to tell you that, for example, Allah is a personality, has got a fitrat, and is defined by his attributes, the names of Allah. Like Allah is Ar-Rahman, most gracious, Ar-Rahim, most merciful, Al-Wudud, most loving, and on and on. There are above 99 attributes and names describing about Allah. So we do not say there are 99 Allahs or gods, astaghfirullah. We say that Allah is described with his attributes and names. They are the description of Allah's personality, how he is. He is Ghafoor, he is Rahim, merciful, forgiving. This is the attribute. Similarly, the book of Allah, like the Bible I hold in my hand, when I said the book contain books. Similarly, I hold in my hand is a book. In that book are ayats. And when we read, that is Quran. Quran means reading. Iqra means read. A command, Iqra, read. Quran means reading. So what the books contain, basically is a book. Allah refers this book as the book also. And it also refers as Quran. There is a difference. But we understand the book has got above 32 attributes, above 33 attributes mentioned in this book. So first I will read the names of this page, that they are the attributes of the book. And they are, the Quran is an attribute, means the reading of the book. Al-Kitab means the book. Al-Kitab means the written one, or the book I hold in mind. This is the book. But it contains these words that I am reading. They contains in these, the book contains these words in Arabic, and that is At-Tawrah, meaning the law. Al-Injil, meaning the good news. Al-Zabur means the peace. Al-Furqan means the criterion. Burhan means the proof. Sultan means the authority. Al-Hikmah, the wisdom. Hidayah, the guidance. Nazil, the revelation. Wahi, inspiration. Kalamun, speech or word. Basairun, insight. Ayat, signs. Al-Majid, the glorious. Al-Ajib, the amazing. An-Nur, the light. Asl Hadith, the most beautiful narration or incident or event. Asl Qasas, the most beautiful relationship. Al-Amthal, the examples. Al-Mu'izah, the sermon. Al-Dhikr, the remembrance. Al-Wah, the tablets. Dhiyaun, the shine. Bayyinat, clarification. Risalat, the messages. Al-Anba, the prophecy. Al-Qawl, the saying. Suhuf, the pages. Sharia, the way. Al-Amr, the order. Al-Haq, the truth. Al-Ilm, the knowledge. These words have occurred in the book of Allah. These words. All these words that I have read, the reference are given. I didn't read the reference. I just want to clarify that these words have occurred in the book of Allah, in the Arabic. They have got their meanings. I have read the meanings. So the book contains these words. They are the qualitative or the description of the book. They are just like Allah is described by his attributes and names. Similarly, the book is described by his attributes and names. So the book of Allah contains these words, and they are the descriptive names of the book of Allah. So Allah has not 99 above 99 gods, neither there are many books. There is one book, and we will see how. So now I will read the ayat, which will explain the topic about the Torah, the word, that means the law. Al-Injil, the Injil means the good news or the gospel or the glad tidings. According to the ayahs, we will read. But first of all, we will read the difference or the understanding between Quran and Al-Kitab. Al-Quran is Arabic word. Al-Kitab is also an Arabic word. How Allah explained these two, we go to Yunus 10 and ayah 37. That is also the staple page. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ أَن يُفْتَرَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ وَلَكِن تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ la rayba fihi min rabbil alameen. And this Al-Quran, the reading is not that can be produced from other than Allah, but it is a confirmation that is between his two hands and an explanation of Al-Kitab, the book. There is no doubt in it from the Lord of the worlds. If you look into the ayah again carefully, the word Arabic Quran has occurred. وَمَا كَانَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ. This Arabic word Quran has occurred in the ayah in Arabic. And in the fourth portion of this, it is referred as وَتَفْصِيلَ الْكِتَابِ. The other word is kitab. So Quran and kitab in one verse, in one ayah. So if you look, if you translate these words, you will understand the essence of the ayah. Normally we don't translate. When we translate, then we understand. And this Quran means this reading is not that can be produced from other than Allah, but it is a confirmation that is between his two hands and explanation of Al-Kitab, the book. There is no doubt in it from the Lord of the worlds. So if you will note that I read this ayah in Arabic from the book, it is written in front of me. That is written in front of that you book in your, you people also holding the book in your hands. So when you are holding this book, is a book. And when I am reading the ayah, that is Quran. Quran is the reading of the ayah, of the book. And when I read, it becomes, the Quran is a confirmation. First of all, it verifies what is between your two hands. It is verifying, you can verify that I am reading correctly or wrongly, or I'm reading correct or wrong, you can verify. This reading, Quran means the reading, cannot be produced from other than Allah, but it is a confirmation. What is between his two hands? So you can confirm that the reading is being done correct. It's not been concoction. It is not my own concepts. It's a confirmation. And the second part of this Quran is awa tafsil al-kitab. And it is explanation of the kitab, of the book. Whenever you read any book, then the explanation of that book comes. If you're reading any book of the world, that is reading would be Quran, and the reading of the book would be Quran, and the reading itself, then you will be the book will be explained to you. So if you do not read any book, this book lying down anywhere, Quran or any book, if you're not reading that book, you don't understand anything. Similarly, if you read Al-Kitab, the book of Allah, the ayahs of Allah, the book of Allah, Quran means the reading, it is a confirmation from what is between your two hands. You can confirm the reading and the written down. Written one is confirmed. The reading is confirming the written one and an explanation of the book. Similarly, you're being explained, you're being understanding what you're reading. So this is what Quran is, an explanation of the book, the written one, and a confirmation of the book. The written one. This is Quran, the reading. So now we will go and understand about the word Torah, the topic, what the Quran has to say about the Torah. So in Surah Ali Imran, 3 Surah and Ayah 3, page number 3. نزل عليك الكتاب بالحق مصدقا لما بين يديه وأنزل التوراة والإنجيل مِنْ قَبْلُ هُدَى لِلنَّاسِ وَأَنزَلَ الْفُرْقَانَ. It is he who has revealed over you Al-Kitab, the book, the writing with the truth, confirming what is between his two hands and from before he revealed. Actually, it is written down here. Okay. And before. And from before he revealed At-Tawrah, the law, and Al-Injil, the good news and a guidance for mankind. And he revealed Al-Furqan, the criterion. Okay, it was written before. Now you see, I just read, you read, see the Arabic. You see, the most, because Arabic is the confirmation that I am speaking the truth or not. The Arabic says, Nazzala alayka al-kitab. What I hold in my hand is a kitab, the book. So Allah says, Nazzala alayka al-kitab bil-haq. So it is, the Nazzala means that it is he who revealed over you, that is Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the kitab, the book. Here is not referring as kitab, not Quran. Here is kitab, bil haq, with truth. The word kitab means the book. I have already explained. Musaddiq al-lima bayna yadayhi, and it is a confirming what is between his two hands. Similarly, this book, what I am reading, Quran, it is confirming this kitab. You can verify also what is in between your two hands. It is a confirmation. Wa anzal al-Tawrah wal-Injil, and he revealed the Torah, the law, and the Injil, the good news of the gospel. Min qabl, from before. Hudal linnas, a guidance for mankind. So the Torah, the law, and the Injil, the good news, was revealed from before. A guidance for mankind. This Torah and Injil here in this ayah does not refer to Moses or Jesus. Remember this. You read very carefully, because we are told from the Bible that the Torah was given to Moses. Torah. And the Injil was given to Jesus. I read before in the Bible. We are seeing what the Quran is saying now. Here only the Torah, the word has occurred. Wa anzal at-Tawrah wal Injil min qablu hudal linnas wa anzal furqan. Another word, furqan means the criteria. So here, if you will note that who is revealing? Allah is Allah is revealing over you the book in truth, confirming what is between his two hands, and he also revealed on who? To whom is he revealing? Muhammad, the Torah. And the Torah, he revealed the Torah and the Injil. Min qablu, from before, a guidance for mankind. This Torah, the law. This Injil, the good news, is a guidance for mankind. Wa anzal furqan, and he revealed the furqan, the criterion. So they are four different words, if you note, in the one ayah. And the revelation is given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and through him we get this message. Meaning the revelation is on the book, he revealed the kitab, and he revealed the Torah, the law, and he revealed the Injil, the good news of the gospel, and he reveals the Furqan, the criterion. Four things are revealed. We are reading the Quran now. We are seeing in the Quran, and the purpose of the revelation of the Torah, the law, and the Injil, the good news, is a guidance for mankind from before. In all times, the Torah, the law, was a guidance for mankind from before. Not now new, it is the guidance from before. Then mankind was taking guidance from the Torah, the law, Injil, the good news, from before. Still now, no Musa salam is mentioned, no Isa salam is mentioned. It is maybe mentioned when you see other ayahs. But at the moment we know that the purpose from here, this ayah, we come to know that the kitab is revealed, the book is revealed on Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a confirmation what is between his two hands, and he revealed the Torah, the law, and he revealed the Injil, the good news, which is a guidance for mankind from before. And Wanzalat Furqan, and he revealed the Furqan, the criterion, which is another attribute of the Quran, the reading. This is the understanding. Now we will see what is the Torah. First we will discuss what is the Torah.